Any of you who were around in the 70s remember that decade, I'm sure, and know that it was a time of experimentation. A lot of artists from all walks of life tried really to push the envelope, and George Crumb was no different. As you read in your programs, we have to play a number of other instruments than our own, and also play our own instrument in rather unusual ways. Sometimes we're imitating a bamboo flute, or the sound of ancient viols, or using extreme pressure to get the undertones. And there's tam-tams, those lucky guys get to play the tam-tams. And crystal glasses, which three of us have to play. And these little maracas. Crumb has us play, in the case of the viols, we have to hold our instruments upside down and actually bow upside down as well. And he says, with a little practice, we'll get used to the fact that when the pitch needs to go up, we have to go down. A little bit of this. And I think he may have been mistaken about the little practice. It is really hard, but we'll do our best. So this piece, of course, is intellectually fascinating. The score is a work of art in itself. You can see it's just beautiful to look at, and every page is like that. He even gives a diagram at the beginning that itself I think is rather beautiful. But I think we can enjoy it on a more sentient level rather than intellectual. Maybe letting the eerie sound kind of wash over us, and it would be nice to feel transported to a world where there's no Santa Claus parade or TTC mishaps. We hope to accomplish that today.
Thank you. fuck.